a lot of people may be watching this and they're thinking that I see it every, we see it every day. I don't want to put words in your mouth, but a 30-something-year-old thinking their life's over. What advice do you give to someone in their 30s and 40s that's in a position that you were in when you were in your 50s?
Right.
Because you come full circle. There's a whole nother chapter we didn't even scratch, which is your successful company today.
Right.
What do you say to them?
I say if you haven't built a successful network of people that can save you, you're crazy. Because what saved me was my network. And I'll give you an example.
Yeah, please.
So I'm looking for a job. So who do I call? I call everybody I know. And several people were interested, but they had jobs that I was not interested in. So I kept, I'd walk every day.
Okay.
Right? I was unemployed for 3 months. I had enough money to last me maybe 5 or 6 months. But I figured if I could find something to sell, because I'm a pretty good salesperson, I'd be fine. And so a guy that used to work for me, I actually had dinner with him on Thursday night.
Like this week?
This week.
Oh, wow.
He wound up being the president of AstraZeneca in China. Now, I hired him as a sales rep in 1986.
Wow.
And now, of the people that I hired, of the 20 people I hired, 13 of them got promoted. So I had a great track record for hiring, you know, people with upside potential. But so anyway, he calls me on the phone and asked me to do a speech. And I said, well, why do you, and I'm broke. And I got no money coming in, and I can't find anything to sell, and I got no job. So he says, I want you to do a speech. I said, for what? He said, well, I got 67 people in the marketing department. They all want to hold hands, sing songs. No, nobody wants to be accountable for anything. And you're the most motivational speaker I've ever heard. And I want you to come in and motivate them to get accountable. And I said, well, you're wasting your money. And I said, now, I got to be honest with you. I could use the money. But for you to think that I'm going to change these people's behavior, which I'm assuming is your goal, with a speech is idiotic because I'm not going to do that. So he said, well, what do I need? I said, well, you need a consulting project from somebody who really understands change management. And what they need to do is to work closely for 6 months with you and your leadership and engender the exact change that you want to engender. And then maybe in the middle of that, there's a speech. But there's a project there.
Yeah.
And he said, can you do that? And I said, yes, I can. I said, I have developed this change management process just inadvertently while I was working at the other company because I saw such barrier to change. So I went back and I did a retrospective analysis of all the change that I had tried to lead that had not done well. And I came up with the fact that there are 6 elements of a successful change management program. 2 of them are the places where most change breaks down. Most people don't understand what they are. So I said, I can do it. So he said, well, send me a proposal. Now, I don't even have a company. So I walked down the street to a lawyer, and I say, create me an LLC and call it Delta Leadership Group. Now, I and Marianne are the leadership group. Marianne's my wife. Now, we got a 1-year-old.
Yeah.
But now I got a project for $45,000. And so in the middle of that project, he says to me, well, you were number one in every product that we sold when you were my district manager. We were number one 7 out of 8 years. And so he said, can you help us learn how to sell this product? It's $350 million at the time. And he said, you're a genius at that. I mean, you go ride with, you know, really smart people and you come back and tell us what to do. And we were successful with every product. And I said, he said, you think you could do that? And I said, probably could. So he said, send me a proposal. So now I got my second proposal. That one was $75,000. So literally, I've gone from broke to $125,000 in 3 months.
And this is the early 2000s?
This is 2001. That's when I started my company.